Yes, hallelujah, praise God, from whom we say always that out of him flows all things. His goodness is unsearchable, the psalmist said. Oh, what an awesome God we serve. What a great deliverer. Faithful and true, he introduces himself to John. He is indeed faithful and true. Hallelujah. Praise God. Dearly beloved, come your way again. We magnify God and we exalt him for the privilege that he gives us to share. We share with amazing people like you who are willing to receive the word and run with it. So bless God that you have been part of my joy in all these months of our podcast. We are grateful. Eagles Nest Foundation is grateful. Reverend Jocelyn is grateful. So grateful. Anyway, we come to the penultimate podcast on our heroes and heroines. And today we're going to look at some amazing women, some awesome, some amazing, fabulous women who took the word of God, who changed the course of history. Jesus had 3.5 years of ministry on earth. From the very first day he was born to his 30th, to the day he was baptized, very little was known about him, but we knew that he helped his father in his business. But when he came to his heavenly father's business, he only worked for 3.5 years. And I believe and I'm confident of this fact, that it was because of these amazing women that Jesus was able to execute this great job, this assignment, this quick assignment that he had on earth in the time that he had. Oh yes, he prayed. He was a prayerful person. He understood the importance of prayer back in the ministry. But it was also, there was only also an essence that pushed the ministry forward in a way that was amazing for him to be able to fulfill that 3.5 years assignment. And I'm going to talk about these women. These women who made it happen. And according to Luke chapter 8, verses 2 to 3, these are the women who made it happen. And we want to look at their achievements. Hallelujah. And so Luke 8, verses 2 to 3, the Bible says, "And certain women who had been healed of evil spirits and infirmities, naming Mary called Magdalene, out of whom had come 7 demons, and Joanna, the wife of Susa, Herod's steward, and Susanna, and many others, who provided for him from their substance." Hallelujah. So, this is it. Some, Bible says, certain women who the Lord himself had healed of evil spirits and infirmities. Jesus' ministry was marked with miracles, signs, and wonders. There was never a dull day with our Savior when it comes to the manifestations of his power. He, against all odds, walked on water. He fed thousands and thousands and thousands of people with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. There was never a time that this great king amongst men was lacking in power. Never. And he healed the sick. He raised the dead. He cast out demons. Lepers were cleansed. Oh, hallelujah. But we never hear that any of these people that Jesus, a blind Bartimaeus, the Talita Kumis, the child who was dead and Christ raised from the dead, all those great people, all those awesome people that Christ healed. We can't name them all. There was never a time in scripture the Bible says that because of what he did for them, these people came back and supported his ministry. No. They didn't support the ministry, his ministry. It was some women, certain women, grateful women who understood the worth and the importance of Christ's assignment. After they came into faith and also came into understanding that for this work, for this assignment to be able to be executed at the right time, he needs our support, and they were determined to give him the support for him to finish the job. And so the Bible says that certain women, and he names them. One, he says, Joanna. So who is Joanna? Joanna simply means whom Jehovah has graciously given. So this woman's name meant that Jehovah has graciously given. God has blessed her. He has blessed her. And what did he do with the blessings? She made sure the work of God advanced. Hallelujah. She was a wife of Susa, a steward of Herod Antipas, Tetrarch of Galilee. And the Bible says she was one of the women who ministered to our Lord, and to whom also he appeared to after his resurrection. Oh my goodness. We are going somewhere with this, and I want you to bear with me. Jesus appeared to some people, 500 people, the Bible says. And this woman, Joanna, was one of them. Why? Because when he was alive, she ministered to him. She was a stateswoman. She was a great woman of influence at the time. She had a bit of wealth. And she didn't shy away because her husband was amongst the elites. Oh, she ministered to our God. Dearly beloved, what are you doing? What do you want to do with what God has given you? Are we really grateful for the fact that Christ has set us free and there is so much that we can do for him? Yeah, we are church members. And then what? Oh, yes, we go to church. We serve, we worship. And then what? Are we really ministering to God with the gift, the grace, the talents, and especially the money he's given us? Or we are holding back? This woman didn't hold back. So we're moving on to another one, also called Susanna. Susanna literally means lily. The Bible says she was a pious woman who also did what? Ministered to Jesus. A pious woman who ministered to Jesus. She was one of the people who gave, supported. Listen, Jesus had 12 disciples. And then from the very day he said, follow me, none of them went back to work until after his death. You understand? And so everything that had to be given to these men to hold the ministry as they traveled from one town, one city, one nation to the other, it didn't just happen. Jesus wasn't taken from the heavenly vault. He didn't carry gold and silver, pave, and all the precious stones from heaven with him when he came on earth. No. Whatever was given him at his birth when the wise men came was used when he was born. So in his life, in his ministry, the time of his ministry, he needed monies. He needed money to be able to travel to feed the 12 with him. And also even some of them had children. Some of them had wives, according to scripture, and mother-in-laws. So it was these women's substance that made it possible for Jesus to execute, to minister, to travel, to go places that he had to go. The Gadara demoniac to travel cross to the other side to deliver a man. It didn't just happen because he was anointed. some women ministered. They gave out of their substance. Are you one of them? Think about it as we proceed. And then there was Mary Magdalene. Oh, you wouldn't have met more gracious woman than that. She came from the town of Magdala, the western shores of the Lake of Tiberias. Oh, hallelujah. She was ministered to by Christ when Jesus cast out demons from her. 7 demons, the Bible says. And out of her gratitude, the Bible says, what? She was able to give to Jesus from her substance and became a follower. And these precious women, according to Matthew 27 and 55, Mark 15, 41, and Luke 23, 55, they accompanied Jesus. They accompanied Jesus even to his last journey to Jerusalem. They followed him. They followed him. Not just following him. They were pushing the vision. They were pushing the vision with their substance. Every step of the way. How would you support somebody if you sit back? They were with him. So that at every given time when there was a need, these women gave out of their substance. They gave. Willingly gave. And then we come to Mary also, the sister of Martha and Lazarus. That woman didn't hold back. One sitting in the home of Simon the leper. There's Simon who was healed from leprosy. When he invited Jesus, he didn't even wash his feet. He left him there. He wasn't grateful. But Mary broke all protocol, came, broke the customs of their time. Women don't go where men sit. She went and ministered to Jesus with a whole year's income of a perfume. Bought a perfume with a whole year's income. That day, it messed the whole system up. It messed the disciples and above all, Judas Iscariot. After that, that's it. This Jesus must die. Because how can people minister to him so much that they are able to just pour 1 year's income on his feet? He has to die. Dearly beloved, do you want to be one of the people that will break protocols and boundary lines and stretch yourself for your king? You could be. You don't necessarily have to be a woman, but if you're a woman, yes. This is it. You can be one of these notable, these certain women who made the ministry of Jesus happen. Hallelujah. And this is it. Precious, amazing women. Powerful. Powerful, influential women. You don't hear much about them. But the Bible says in Luke chapter 24, verse 10, it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, the mother of James, and other women with them, who told these things to the disciples. And their words seemed to them like idle tales, and they didn't believe them. Jesus, my God. These women didn't just follow Jesus in his life, even after death. When the disciples were hiding for the fear of the Jews, these women came out of their rooms, followed, stayed at the tomb of Jesus. They went there early morning to see what was going to happen. And so they were the first witnesses of Christ's resurrection. And it didn't stop there. They were the ones who went and told the disciples, the Savior, our Savior is risen. And the Bible says what? And their words seem like idle tales. And they didn't believe them. They didn't believe them. The first women who preached the gospel of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And now people are debating. Some church communities are, should women preach? Who were the first people that Jesus entrusted the message of resurrection to? Women. Certain women. The first message of his resurrection was entrusted into their hands. He said, go tell my disciples. Go tell. So what is go tell? Isn't that preaching? Like I'm doing? Go tell that it is I who was dead and I'm alive. I'm alive. I am the living God, the Savior of humanity. Go tell them. Go tell them. When the woman of Samaria spoke about, the Samaritan woman went and told the whole city that, I have come and see a man. Did Jesus rebuke her because she was a woman? No. Actually, Jesus deliberately set her up because he knew that through her, the men will follow, the men of the city. These adulterous and idolatrous men. These men who worshipped anything else apart from God. And that is why the Jews had no dealings with the Samaritans because of their idolatry. This woman went. Jesus set her up to go and bring the men for their salvation. What are you talking about? You have a mission to go out there and tell. And this woman didn't stop. Just giving their substance. See, sometimes we think, okay, yeah, it's okay. If you want to stop on substance giving, that's fine. But I believe there are some times that you can also tell. But we need people who will push the ministry forward. Certain powerful women, notable women, women who are fearless, who are able to rise up even when men are scared to say that, yes, I am going to where the action is. I'm going where the Lord, even if it costs my life. Because you see, the disciples were afraid. But this woman said, we are not afraid. We are going where our Savior is. Even if the soldiers kill us. But did they say soldiers there? They were like dead men, the Bible says. But Christ revealed himself to these precious women and told them, go and tell my disciples that I'm alive. Dearly beloved, this is it. This is it. Certain women. These are the heroes that we don't hear much about. These are the heroes. These are the heroes. They made Jesus' ministry happen. 3.5 short and sweet years. Powerful years. Jesus didn't have to think about what he's going to feed the people with, his disciples, how to take care of their families. He wasn't negligent. He knew that the families must be provided for those who are married. He didn't tell them, dump them somewhere and follow me and don't think about them. Obviously, he ministered to them. He gave them enough to take care of their homes. That is Jesus. That is God. He doesn't call us and tell us to neglect the important things in our lives, our families. And so, but these women made it happen. These precious women made it happen. You will have to make it happen. If God has given you substance, you have to think just as this notable women did, this certain women did, these precious women did. They didn't sit. They were grateful enough to push the ministry of Jesus Christ forward. And I know you will too, because God is counting on you. The time is so short. We don't have the luxury of time anymore. Our Savior is coming back. But it will take substance to push the ministry through. And I know for those of us who are listening and you have, be gracious. Be gracious to your ministry. Sponsor ministries that are making impact and having influence on your lives. Make it happen. Be the one that will send somebody to say, our Savior is risen. Indeed. God bless you. God bless you. And thank you for listening and sharing, downloading and encouraging many with us. If you're a woman and you have money, I just spelled it out to you. Use this so that Jesus' kingdom will come quickly. In the name of Jesus. God bless you all. Love you guys. And if you're a man too, go do it. Hallelujah. So see you again by the grace of God next week, Monday. So have a fantastic weekend. Till we meet again, we say, Shalom, shalom, shalom. Blessings.